Following the catastrophic failure of an air conditioning compressor, it is absolutely vital that when the system is repaired, every square inch of the refrigerant path is either new or has been thoroughly flushed. In this video, we will show that with a few modifications, a standard flush bottle can easily be adapted to ensure that all the oil and solvent are removed from the evaporator. The key to removing all the contaminated oil from the evaporator using a flush bottle is to maintain the solvent momentum as it is expelled from the bottle and passes through the evaporator. This can be achieved by connecting dry shop air directly to the flush bottle with an air hose nipple and regulator. We will connect the flush bottle outlet directly to the evaporator outlet with a custom adapter, and also attach a drain hose to the evaporator inlet. Always flush the evaporator in the opposite direction of normal refrigerant flow. With this setup, a constant flow of air through the flush bottle and evaporator can be maintained even after all the solvent has been dispensed. Start the flush by setting the pressure at 40 psi. When all the solvent has been expelled from the flush bottle, increase the pressure to 80 psi and continue to purge the evaporator with air for at least another 30 minutes. This is absolutely necessary to ensure that all traces of oil and solvent are removed from the evaporator.